The day began with some optimism as it was believed there was a chance the arriving players to their meeting in Washington, D.C. would produce the basis of an agreement with the owners. But in his opening comments to reporters, NFLPA President Kevin Mawai was frank in his assessment.
Make no mistake about it, the players are not in a rush to get it to we're not tied to the timeline of July 21st. Our timeline is that which gets us the deal that's the best deal for our players. So whether that's today or tomorrow or whatever it may be, we want to play football, we want to go back to work, but we're not going to agree to any deal unless it's the right deal for all the players.
Hours later, the meeting broke up as the players had flights to catch, and for football fans, the news was not good. According to a person familiar with the negotiations, no vote on a full proposal had been taken.
Wednesday was a very inconclusive day, unfortunately. Most people were expecting that the NFLPA would be able to vote on a settlement to the lockout. But the former union felt that it had not gotten enough information to make an informed vote, and also that there were outlying issues that still have not been solved.
That said, the person who spoke to the AP said there was agreement on what items need to be resolved before any offer would be accepted. A second person, also speaking on a condition of anonymity because the talks are supposed to be secret, said those players gave what was termed conditional approval of the proposal as it stood Wednesday. Wilner says the time has come to get serious.
The NFL and the NFLPA are up against some hard deadlines now, and they've gotten to a point where the preseason could be affected, the opening of training camps, maybe even the playing of games. So they must reach an agreement pretty soon or they start losing money. And that's the thing they've not really had a problem with so far. This has been an offseason where they've lost a little bit of money. Now we're talking significant millions of dollars if the preseason is disrupted.
As the players drove off from Wednesday's meeting, the owners gathered in Atlanta for their meeting Thursday. Jack Briggs, The Associated Press.